Ladies and gentlemen, the Baghdad Theater proudly presents the First Lady of Comedy, that knockers up gal, Miss Rusty Warren.
Stand well back, let me through. Tonight is gonna be the night. I got things to tell you. Rusty's gonna treat you right. You'll learn to bounce your boobies, the right pill to use, how to get life from a fizzled out fuse. Flip it, flop it, just don't drop it. Tonight is gonna be the night. Now that you're here, I think it's time you'll learn what sex is all about. Listen close to every rhyme and you'll never be in doubt. I'll tell you all the ways to do it, except for three. I tell you those, honey, but they're my job guarantee. Flip it, flop it, just don't drop it. Tonight is gonna be the night. Uh-huh. Well, here's where the sexy people are. You gotta get out and get it while the getting is good. You gotta stoke the fire before you run out of wood. The Peter Rabbit habit is the only cure. It beats cold showers, Daddy, that's for sure. Kick your heels high, relax and lay back. Now see how that tingles in your sacroiliac. Man loves woman, but oh, what a crime. You say, do you beat your wife? He says, hell, every time. So I say, here's to sex, and it's time your plans were made. Try it tonight, see if it checks. You'll be happy once your plans are laid and laid. Just think you'll have mastered a trade. You may have a little dinghy or a great big yacht, but unless you launch it, Daddy, it all goes to pot. Flip it, flop it, just don't drop it. Tonight is gonna be the night. That's right, tonight is gonna be the night. You know, fellas, if you're having trouble with your sex life, I want you to take a little hint from Rusty. When you leave here tonight, I want you to drive into a Shell service station. Order a glass of platformate. Have her drink it down, and I'll guarantee she'll go further than she's ever gone before. 'Cause tonight is gonna be the night. Well, good evening. As most of you know, we have gathered here this evening to discuss a very intimate subject, sex. And I want to thank each and every one of you for coming in here tonight and giving it up so we can talk about it. No, there's a lot of fellas sitting here tonight say, I didn't give up nothing, baby. Because he figures he's going to take his wife in to see my show, and I'm going to talk about something she may have forgotten about, and I'll remind her, and he'll take her home, and woo! Don't laugh, sir, any other town but Las Vegas. For some reason or other, sex and gambling don't mix. I don't know why. Oh, there's a guy that ain't getting it right over there, yeah? And for you people that have come in here for a wild, mad, sexual weekend, what happened when you first got in? You don't even go to the room. Bring the bellhop, let him take the bags. What are you gonna look at? He got two dresses, one for the afternoon, one for the evening, a pair of slacks and shoes. He's got clean underwear, two shirts. What the hell he has to look at? He packed it 2 hours ago. Where's he going? He doesn't want to miss anything. Oh boy, I know this is gonna be our lucky weekend. Let me tell you, Alice, this is going to be so lucky you won't believe it. And as he walks up and down the casino, Alice is right behind him. And then we have the $10 for the nickels. You promise me you give me $10. Honest to God, I won't bother you. Just give me the money. I'll leave you alone. I'll never see you for hours, days, whatever you want. Just give me the nickels. And she takes her nickels and goes over to her machine. Hasn't been here in a year and a half, but that's still her machine. She doesn't forget it. It's almost like another husband. Because that machine is a large steel edifice of challenge. It stands there cold, strong, defying, with that long steel handle. Now, if this isn't a challenge to a woman that's been married over 15 years, I don't know what the hell is. that she controls it in a way. Because any woman knows if you feed a man long enough, he'll come through for you right there. As she looks at this big iron machine with a long handle, she is going to beat this machine because this big mechanical iron machine is man. It is man because she looks at it and has a big iron stick. Well, she controls. That stands there with that assuming beautiful masculine arm, long and steel and wide and ready for her. And as she feeds it tenderly at first, throws the nickels in. And that machine doesn't do a damn thing and she gets mad at it. And she feeds the nickels faster and faster, and all of a sudden it just teases her a little bit. Dribbles a few dimes, nickels, and little goodies here. And all of a sudden that machine is getting warm and she can feel it. It's like passion. As she's feeding the nickels in, she decides she'll feed it slower, play with the handle a little bit. Baby, that'll help. Am I right? See? Is it sexual? Look at her poking him. And she gets madder and madder, and she feeds more and more and more. And all of a sudden, it happens. You know it happens because you can hear her. It's almost sexual. It's exciting. All of a sudden, the lights go on, and she goes, ah! She made $2.50. And you're over at the craft table saying, oh, God, that's Alice again. He's got $25 a number going, and she's yelling about $2.50 over there. He could kill her. Sex and gambling, I don't have to kid you people, you know. A man is so full of the urge to gamble. When he takes a break and walks into any of our clubs, he sees all the sex he has to see. Those ugly 21-year-old broads up there with those naked knockers hanging on. Most disgusting thing I've ever seen on. Isn't that sickening, sir? Isn't it, sir? Isn't it the most revolting thing you ever see? You're not a knocker man, right? He's sitting there saying, yeah, I don't like them. Yeah, it's pretty bad. I've had women that have come into Las Vegas and have been murderous. They've got their hair done. They bought a new dress. This is a big thing. Las Vegas for the weekend with their very own husband. Get away from the kids. And as soon as you hang up, say, nighty-night, kitty darlings. Bye-bye, mummy. Say nighty. Dad, dad, say night-night. Ha-ha. Put the thing down, baby. Where are you? Right? The minute the phone is on a hook and he's saying, shh, don't bother me. I got to get a shower and get out of here right now. I got a hot streak coming on. She waits, maybe Friday night, Saturday night, you gotta leave Sunday. She went, when's her big day gonna be? Oh, great white father, did you not promise to give her a little this weekend? Oh, he's too busy. If he isn't gambling, he's cashing checks, he's saying, okay, honey, tonight's the night. Get ready. She's ready. She's been ready since she got off the plane, she's ready. She is so gorgeous tonight, you don't even know it's your wife. She looks beautiful. She looks lovely. She smells beautiful. And everything is fine. Go find him, young lady. Go find him. Because all you see is his fanny belt over a bent over a crap table, right? And you go around, you look at all the fannies, you say, that's his right there. Right? Because after 12, 15 years, you can recognize what the hell it looks like. There it is. Hey, honey. Honey, let's go. You dinner? Yeah, let's see a show. And a shh, shh. Don't bug me. It's a hot roll. This is gonna be it. This is the fence, right? The new fence we're gonna build, the new refrigerator we're gonna get. Everything is gonna be fine. Watch it, baby. Don't bug me. Get out of here. 7-0. Next roller. This is it. This is it, baby. He's running out of money. He says, come on. Give me the money I told you not to give me. Give me. Give me. Come on, give it to me. She says, it's in my bra. I don't give a damn where it is. Give it to me right now. Right? She says, I can't do that. It's in my bra. It's all in front of all these people. Drop your bra. Give me the money. Don't start with this booby business. I don't give a damn about it. Just give me the money. I know that you ladies that have come here with your very own husbands are all dressed, the hair is ready, the clothes, everything. Wow, beautiful weekend in Las Vegas, and you won't get any. Honest to God, you just won't get it. I know one woman got so damn mad, ran naked into the gambling room, laid stark naked on a crap table. Her husband's at the other end saying, "Lady, would you move your knocker? You're on my point." They get so engrossed in this, they don't know what's happening. They don't even know who the hell's knocker it is. Oh, single couples, try and bear with us. And he's sitting there going, "Yeah, yeah, baby, yeah, baby." That's the only luck right here in the audience is this group right over here. A single lady and a date, of course, an escort. And you look around at all these married people. Could you wonder, I started to tell you, they ain't going to get it. They're not going to get it. Did you know? Who's going to get it? The single people that I don't know. That's because married people are too busy. They know they got it there. Tomorrow it's going to be there. The next day it ain't going anywhere. Right? You got to meet, you got to see Alice and George in a week and a half. Where are you going to go? You got a wedding to go for in 2 months. But this guy, he doesn't know when she's going to go out with him again. I wasn't kidding you when I said tonight's tonight. It's tonight. Now she's looking at me. Don't do that to me. Don't you say that, because I'm not going to be obligated because you stand up here and say it. I do not say it that you're going to do it. But tonight's going to be the night for him. Because if you don't give it to him, I will, because I mentioned it right here. You wouldn't let me do that, would you? She says, "Give him what? What are you going to give him?" Just flip the pages in the little book in the side there. You're fine. Yes, I can tell we have not only a gambling audience here tonight, but a sexual one. Visitors from out. Ha-ha, there's a lady that's going to get it, right? You have no faith. Look at the man's face over there. He's sitting there, who's going to get what? What? Said, "I haven't had it in a month. Why is tonight going to be any different?" You're going to get it because you came in here and I promised you, sir. What is your name, this delightful gentleman who's going to get it tonight? What is your name?
Alf.
Alf? Alf. With a foof on it, right? All right, and what's the young lady that's going to give it to you? What is her first name? You don't know yet. His wife's sitting there and Amy, I don't know who's going to give it to her. Alf, you're going to have me tonight. We're going to run a raffle. No laugh, lady. It's the only way I get it. I got to run a raffle. See, they buy the tickets. They don't know what it's for, because no matter where you go in Las Vegas, they're running tickets and games. They give you free nylons, free mink coats, free everything. Tonight, it's going to be me. Are you ready, Alf? You might be lucky. I'll fix the thing. Don't worry. I'll fix the raffle. You're going to win. Would you like to buy a ticket to the raffle, sir? It don't cost too much. 10-cent ticket. That's cheap enough, isn't it? For charity. He don't want me. Where the hell the money goes, he don't care. But me, he ain't gonna win. Well, I don't care, sir, because people get a very weird idea. When I stand up here and yell about the knockers and scream about poontang and everything, they think, well, boy, I bet this broad gets lucky every night. Oh, all the goodies happen. Whee! Don't laugh, lady. Nothing ever happens to me. I got a beautiful suite here, 2.5 rooms, me and the dog living it. No, I got a little toy poodle named Tiz, cutest little thing you ever saw. I take her out for a walk in the morning, up and down the boulevard. I go, "Here, Tiz. Here, Tiz. Here, Tiz. Here, Tiz." I don't get nothing. My dog don't even get it. And she's fixed. But it's sort of funny, and I start to think about why don't I get it, because I stand in front of you delightful people, and I talk about knockers and boondang and all that jazz and the boobies and everything. These delightful gentlemen sitting tonight, they're scared to death of me. They say, "I ain't gonna ask her, she's gonna say no." I never say no. The only time I say no is when they've asked me if I've had enough. But when you stop to think of it, who are the lucky people here tonight? Every married man in this audience tonight is a lucky man. Just think of it, sir. Anytime you want it, there it is, laying next to you. Wild, wanting, needing, ready. Alfie, what do you say? I'm wrong, right? Men know more about sex because they start before women do. I want to know if they start before women, who the hell they starting with? Hey, isn't this a crazy world? Because our complete sexual timing is off. It really is. They say, well, you know, now that men know more, that when you get married, all you have to do is lay there and wait for directions. Because your mother told you that, and her mother told her, and nobody knows nothing. Only the men know, because they're brought up to know. Automatically, they evolve into some beautiful masculine mentality of an Encyclopedia Britannica. They walk around with all kinds of sexual knowledge. Oh, yeah, and they're going to help the whole world with this knowledge. He's going to give it to you and you alone, this beautiful gift. Don't laugh, lady. He's educated it. And you're not supposed to know anything about it, so therefore you stay in there and say, all right, tell me what I'm supposed to do, ho, ho, ha, ha. And the minute you ad lib, he said, where'd you learn it? What, what, what? Where? Why are you moving that way? Who told you to do that? Who did? Your mother didn't tell you that. She never told you what worked. And boy, honey, if you do not have the correct timing in this world today, you're dead. We're going to take a survey here tonight. I want to test all the men and their sense of timing here. I want all the married men to please stand up. Come on, boys, don't be bashful. Just go ahead, stand up. Attaboy, stand up, that's right. What's the matter, you're too pooped to get up there? There we go. Beautiful. There we are. All right, don't go away. I want all the married men who'll get it once a week to please march. Don't sit down. Oh, fellas, don't sit down. Boy, you really are pooped out, you guys, aren't you? All right, I want all the men who'll get it once a month to please rise. Hut, 2, 3, 4, hut. There's some more came up in the back of the room. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now I want all the men who get it anytime they want it to please stay seated. Boy, you sat down fast enough, didn't you? Boy, there's a lot of sex maniacs here tonight. That's all I can say. The lap lady, you're next. I want all the single girls who plan to give it their escorts tonight right after the show to please rise and take a pill. This is a public service announcement. And I'd want all the married women who give it to their husbands anytime they want it, on land or sea or in the air, when the cleaning man is delivering, during a PTA meeting regardless of risk, even missing paint and place, always ready on your back 24 hours a day to please stand up and be commended. Is there not a woman here amongst you? Here's one in the back of the room. There she is. Thank you very much. Oh, good God, lady, you can't do that here. Now stop it. Come on now, cut that off. You gotta have timing. Timing. Well, you're marching or laying in your bed. Left, right, marching to your bed at night. Come on, girls, get some start. Batten down your snatches, mod. Show them what this gun is really for. You gotta have timing. Timing. Oh, that's the way to win the war. Oh, we are a wild group tonight.